Today you're going to find out if expensive smartwatches are more accurate than the cheap ones. I bet you already have a guess, so comment that down below and watch till the end of the video if you're right. Oh hi, I'm actually testing out 4 smartwatches here if the step counts are accurate. This is a $500 smartwatch, a $200 smartwatch, a $40 smartwatch and a $30 smartwatch to see and find out if an expensive smartwatch is more accurate than the cheaper ones. You want to find out that one too, right? Come on, let's go. Right, so we have all the fitness trackers on one arm to make sure they all get consistent arm movement and find out if they detect the same step reading. These fitness trackers already have some steps detected while we were shooting the video, so we will be taking note of them and deduct the final step count. I'll be manually counting my steps and compare it with the final step count. And let's see which one will be closest to the actual step count. So let's go! Alright, so just a quick backstory here. So why I got smartwatch or a fitness tracker. Before, I used to work on a desk job, and you know how desk job works, you know, you sit the entire day and stress out yourself. One day I got sick and my doctor told me that I have a heart problem, so he advised me to get active and avoid sedentary life, and he even advised me that I quit my job, and if I can't quit my job I should look for a way. So hence the fitness tracker. Then the fitness tracker actually helps me to motivate myself to move more, since this has an hourly movement notification. So if you've been sedentary for a few hours, it will tell you to move. And also I've been into step counting, so I have to reach 10,000 to 15,000 15,000 step counts if I run. I alternately run on days, so having a fitness tracker with an accurate heart rate helps me understand why the heart rate actually struggles when you have heart rate. So if you're sick, you actually have high heart rates. Also, if you do not have any enough sleep for many nights or a few nights, basically your heart will struggle and your heart rate for that day will actually be higher than normal. If you are actually eating junk foods or unhealthy foods, there will be days that your body will struggle as well, and your heart rate will indicate that one also. . 300 steps so far. You might want to ask how these smartwatches count steps. Fitness bands use multi-axis inertial sensors called accelerometers to detect when the device is moving. Some also use gyroscopes to determine the direction and rotational movement. Fitness trackers are designed to track repetitive walking motions as steps. Arm movement while walking will be captured by the internal 3-axis accelerometer in the watch and will record each complete swing of the arms as 2 steps. The gyroscope is for the rotation, repetitive counting and swimming, and distance for ultra track if the GPS is up. So why does accurate step count matter? It depends. If you are counting calories, the amount of steps matter, because this will determine the distance that you have walked unless you turn the GPS. Without the GPS, the watch will count your stride length per step and multiply it to the number of steps you made. And the formula of the calories burned includes the distance that you made. So if your step count is not accurate, then your calorie counting will not be accurate as well. Alright, so the difference between an expensive smartwatch and a cheap smartwatch or fitness tracker. So the some, not all, but some of the fitness trackers or expensive fitness trackers has the capability of customizing their stride length. So you can put in your walking stride length and your running stride length, because they are actually different. So unlike cheap smartwatches, you are unable to do that. So your smartwatch will only put in the default stride length to each person according to the height that you entered on the smartwatch. Alright, so that's 500 steps so far. Let's see the results. Alright, so here are the results. So we made 500 steps and we recorded the initial steps that the watches has made and deducted the final count of the steps on the smartwatches. So the $500 smartwatch made 2,694 and the $200 smartwatch made 1,785 and the $40 smartwatch made 2,048. So the $30 fitness band made 2,734. Well, these numbers will be deducted by the initial numbers that was recorded on the initial steps from the fitness trackers. So the $500 smartwatch made 533 steps and the $200 smartwatch recorded 539 and the $40 smartwatch recorded about 548 and the $30 smartwatch recorded the most shocking and amazing result, which is the closest to the manual counting, which is 522. In this, we can say the cheap smartwatches are pretty much accurate, even much more accurate to the step counting. So it's not the price that determines the accuracy of these sensors, but for sure they have put in hardcore hardware and algorithm on these smartwatches to make it closer to the accurate counting. But what really made them expensive are the extra features that you get out of the smartwatches other than the step count and heart rate sensors. But it's not all good. The more features it offers, the shorter the battery life. This $200 smartwatch only lasts 2 days max. And if the battery is longer and having it all, like this 500 smartwatch, it has a battery life of 5 to 7 days, having all sensors and features, but it's less affordable. Right, so if you're like me, I choose the most accurate fitness tracker to get most of your fitness tracking. So unless you just want to know if you need to catch up some steps during the day or just get the satisfaction of having enough steps that you've made, so I guess accuracy may not really matter. But can you say if expensive smartwatches are more accurate than the cheap ones? I would say no. So far with our test, they are actually, the cheaper ones are actually more closer to the manual counting, but they're not really that far of a difference. But can you say cheap smartwatches and expensive smartwatches are more at par or the same level? It's just the branding. I would say no. Expensive smartwatches are packed with features that you don't find in cheap smartwatches, like the sleep tracking are more accurate because they have gyro, they have watch faces, they also have other sensors. You can also connect with them some external sensors, so that's how expensive smartwatches are. The cheap smartwatches, you can't, you just stick with the watch. So with this, I would say if you just need some step counting and feel satisfied that you have done so, you've done steps so far, then you go with the cheap smartwatches. They are same accuracy with the expensive ones. But if you need more features, such as the features that we mentioned, then expensive smartwatches are for you. Alright, so if you like smartwatch videos, click that subscribe button now. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, we have a lot of smartwatch reviews to do. Actually, I have two watches to unbox, and I will be doing a review in the next few days. So don't forget to hit that bell icon to get notified on our next videos on these smartwatches. We got more smartwatch videos. And if you like a giveaway, please like and share this video. If this video actually reaches 50 likes, we'll be giving out a smartwatches that we have reviewed to our viewers. Alright, so yeah, I appreciate you watching this till the end of this video, and thank you for watching. You have a great day.
Right, so the tree fell actually where I was sitting. Right, so this is actually where I was sitting here. I was doing the review, or I was actually doing the video, and the tree actually fell, this tree. So right there. So if I was in the right time, I would be hit by this tree.